This is Cauchy Gauss type theorem. Suppose that we have function fz. Function fz is analytic and singular value also on the region C. This is region C. So here inside and on the path, this is analytic. So fz dz will be equal to, if you take the integral along the closed path C, that will be equal to 0. Now, proof we are taking. Let fz be the any analytic function and single value, this I am supposing, and this is analytic on the C and inside the C. Now suppose that we are dividing this path C in the complete scales also and partial scales also. I will explain later on what is the meaning of that. Now suppose that epsilon we are taking, epsilon is a small value and arbitrary constant also and positive value also. And suppose that z is the point, right, related to each scale, so that fz minus fzi, z minus zi, f dash zi will be less than the epsilon, right? Epsilon is a small constant, arbitrary constant near to zero. This is lemma one. Similarly, now this is path C. So complete scales are there, partial scales are there. I have taken out the complete scale from this part and partial scale also from this part to discuss parameter. If you see the parameter of this complete scale, it means it will be 4ai, right? Means the example I have taken, right? Say 12 centimeters, and partial scale, what a parameter, adding the each side, right? Suppose it is 15 centimeter, because it is more also, because we have this side is bulged out. This is meet means 12 plus 3, the 12 means 4ai, and this is 4ai plus small part li or dl delta li, whatever the case may be. Now we know that this dz is equal to 0 and z dz also 0. Lemma 2. Basically, this is a Cauchy theorem. So now, let nij is less than epsilon, right? This is less than epsilon also. That we also know, since this part is here and this part is there. You compare the both paths. It means this part and this part, they are equal, because this is also less than epsilon and neta is also less than epsilon. So it means both are equal. So modulus we have taken. So open the this modulus, right? Because this is also modulus, this is also most modulus, right? So that can be good. It means this part will be equal to neta z. Further, now fzi, opening the bracket now, this z minus zi will be with this one also and with this one also. Open the bracket. So fz, this fz will be equal to what? Neta I, then multiply with this one, this minus f dash I, f dash I, you can take to other side, right? Multiply by z minus z I, then f z I, we can take to that side also. So it means now integrating this part along the this si means boundary of the square, it can be complete also, it can be partial also. So I am taking the this integration f z as such. This part also, first path, then second part, then third part. Now if you see, first part I am not touching, because neta depend upon z also, and some of this also z minus zi. Now further, if you see this part, this f, this I am opening, how f dash zi will multiply to z also, then minus f dash zi zi dz, as this part is as such. Further, this I have already written, right? You can see here now, in this case, f dash zi is constant quantity, zi is also constant quantity, right? So other things are not constant. Neta doesn't, is not constant here, it depends upon z. How, maybe it is a very small value, but it depends upon z. Further, to take the all and take this constant value out, f dash z i from here, right? Similarly, f dash z I here, f z I here, right? See carefully, this is z dz. Now this is dz only, this is dz only. Integrations are there. That is equal to constant quantity, is equal to zero, is equal to zero, because as per the second lemma, this is Cauchy's theorem. So lemma 2 means this is zero, this is zero, this is zero, and this is zero. Three parts are zero, right? Only one part is left. So this fz dz integration si will be equal to this one only, this part, nothing else. So integral around the closed path C will be equal to sum of integrals around the SI. Line integral along the common boundaries of the complete C, because here we are not, we are seeing scales. Scales can be complete also, it can be partial also. This is the case of, suppose, complete scale. You see the integrals here. This two integrals are opposite direction. This two integrals are also opposite direction to the related to complete scale. This will cancel out because direction is opposite. It means the total effect of the complete scale will be zero. So meaning of this is that these two integrals are related to only the partial scales. Because complete scales effect is already deleted. Further, now if you add all the partial scales in this region C, so add all, this is one partial scale, this one partial I am taking, so all the partial scales I equal to 1 to n, right? If they are added, then that will be equal to the closed path fz dz. So fz dz, this are we already calculated, dz equal to this part, right? Now this and this already written, right? So comparing 4 and 5, right? So this path is here. So it means basically this cfz dz will be equal to what? This part. Compare 4 and 5, so this will be equal to this part. Now taking the modulus, right? So I am taking the modulus, so fz dz modulus as such, then integration past c, then summation, right? Integration along past si, z minus z I as such, then eta I z, modulus of that also, modulus of dz also. This was equal, now this is less than equal. Why? Because this is the property of modulus. If you want to separate the modulus, then the equal sign will be changed to less than equal. Further, you can see we know that neta is less than sign. Here we have neta. Neta is less than the sign also. This value was less than or equal. It means 100% this will be equal to less than eta, final, of final multiply, because eta is less than final. So I am changing this eta with the final, nothing else. Modulus eta change to final. What is left? This z minus z I as such, and dz as such, right? Now, what is z minus z I? That is less than equal to. Less than equal to means it will be equal to AI and 2 or less than that. Why? Equal to. If you see this Z minus Z I, you come this match 2 points, that will be diagonal. Apply the Pythagoras theorem. AI here, AI here. So this Z minus Z I you can calculate. So that is the either equal to this one, that because this is what is that? AI square plus AI square. The 2a is here, right? So length of the path, this diagonal will be what? Ai under 2, right? This zi can be less than that, near to z also, right? Because k is sometimes k, because k is partial, right? So in the case of partial scale, z and zi, this is the maximum distance, right? That is possible. Now z1 is zi less than equal to ai and 2, right? So this we already calculated. So what it did, now this is, if you put the value of z1 is zi here, ai and 2, that is a constant quantity. Ai is a constant and 2 is a constant. It can be taken from outside. So what is left only? So dz, then integration. What is dz integration? Mean this is the length of the one partial square. And partial square, what is that? That is 4ai, a complete square. A partial square is 4ai plus delta I, because this last line may be somewhat bulge out somewhere. So it is 4ai delta li, right? So that is the value. Now it means basically integral value will be less than equal to, means either this is equal or less than that also, right? Because this last side is bulged out, right? Somewhere it may be less bulged out, right? Somewhere it can be near to straight line also. That's why we have written that length of one square will be, partial square will be less than equal to 4ai plus delta li, right? So this dz is less than this one, right? Dz integration further. Now z minus z I have already calculated, right? Then this dz will be equal to what? 4ai delta li, right? Integration along one partial square. So this is there. So open the brackets, less than equal to as such, 4ai square under 2 plus ai delta li and then under 2. So now it means fz dz, right? This we have already calculated. This equals this one, right? So from equation 6 and 7, because this is related to one partial square only, but this is C means combination of all the partial squares. That's why I'm writing I is equal to 1 to n here, right? So putting this value here, this is related to one partial square. This is one partial square. This sigma means combination of all the partial squares. So means total is this less than or equal to of sine law as such. I put the value of z1 is zi d at that this one here. Now from equation 6 and 7, you can write less than or equal to this one. You can see here 4 is constant, ai constant, under 2 is constant, under 2 is constant, ai is constant, delta li constant. All constants are there. It means this factor is constant k, right? And this is less than sine k. And what is opsignal? Opsignal is basically very small value and arbitrary constant. So it is near to zero. What is the meaning of that? It is meaning of that is that fz dz is equal to zero. That is basically the Cauchy-Gauss theorem. Thank you.